One person will be over here with the icing and the Oreos. One person will be over here with their relay ribbon. It's going to take a spoonful of icing. Zay and Lucas will be the ones running back and forth. And you have to smother their face with the icing. Like, you want to get a nice even spread and you want it to look good. And then you have to take the Oreos over their eyes and want it to stay there. It is, it's a time thing. So you want to hurry up and get it done. But at the end, you both have to stop. And then we'll see who, like, whose looks the best and whose was the best.
That stuff is real orange.
That works.
Can someone open up the Oreos, please?
You'll put that on after the fact. You don't need to worry about it.
Kind of.
Do something, man.
So we definitely have just, I'm gonna smear all the icing I want on your face, and then we have, we want it to look good, but have enough to hold an Oreo.
Oh, no!
Hold on, I'm gonna make a layer.
See, I'm gonna make this look good. They're gonna stop coming for me.
Can we put them on the sheets? Will that look like eyes?
No, you have to put it on the eyes.
Taste a little bit. It's good. See, look at me, y'all can't tell me.
Colton, smile.
I put a bunch on like a little sticker.
We also need team names. Come up with team names while you're putting on the icing.
Winners.
Team Winners, Team Gravy Train. They won. Team Gravy Train, final product. I'm just gonna go ahead and give the win to Zay and Colton.
I'm good.
Hey, well, what's up, everybody? I just want to finish out our series called A Haunted Heart by summarizing all of the stuff that we talked about over the last couple of weeks, particularly last week with our friends, as we talked about the subject of fear and how fear is a skeleton in the closet of our heart that often haunts our heart. Don't cancel me here, but one of my biggest fears is spiders. Yeah, you heard it, spiders. I'm putting this out there real confident that this won't be used against me in the future, but if you're watching this today, I want you to know that you don't have to fear. I imagine that some of you right now, as you're watching this, you're probably experiencing some sort of fear. And when you're afraid, it causes you to do some crazy things. Fear can isolate us. Fear can isolate us from being in community with other people who could potentially be an encouragement to us. And if you follow Jesus, fear can keep you from being the best that you can be in light of Jesus and who Jesus has called you to be. And fear is a skeleton in our closet that needs to go. The Bible, it has a lot to say about the subject of fear. There's the fear of the Lord, and then there's just the fear of things, and they're two entirely different meanings. You'll notice that there are verses in the Bible like Proverbs 1:7 that says, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge." And this is the type of good fear, because ultimately it's not saying that we cower in fear. What it's saying is that when we have a fear of God, when we have the fear of the Lord, we are showing respect and honor to him. He's way bigger and way holier than we truly understand. But then there's the negative fear. There's a fear that haunts our hearts, and it can be dangerous to our soul. And overcoming the skeleton of fear is simply this. It's trusting in God. When Joshua was about to lead the Israelites on a dangerous trek into unknown lands that where the inhabitants of that land could have killed them, God commanded Joshua, "Do not fear." When King David was going through some difficult situations during his life and his kingship that would be a reason to fear, he constantly reminded himself in the Psalms, "Don't fear." Fear is focused on everything that's happening around us instead of trusting in the Lord to work it out for us. I might have an irrational fear of spiders, but I know that ultimately God is in control. Let me read this to you out of 1 John 4:18. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear. For fear has to do with punishment, and whoever fears has not been perfected in love. I want to serve a public eviction notice on the skeleton called fear that's been haunting my heart and your heart for far too long. Fear, you must leave. How do we overcome fear? We put our trust and our hope and our faith in God because God loves us. And how can we trust God? It's because God loves us. How does God love us? We know that God loves us because he sent his only son, Jesus, to die on the cross for our sins. And when we accept Jesus as Lord and Savior of our lives, there's no place for fear anymore because we're focused on the eternal love that our Father in heaven has for us, and it's evident through his son Jesus. October might be a month when the cool thing to do and the cool thing to be and the cool thing to focus on is scary. It's fear. But I want you to know that you don't have to be afraid today. Fear has no space in your heart when the love of your heavenly Father, when the love of God is overflowing within you. I want to let you know that God loves you so much that he sent his son Jesus to die for you today.